Here is today's word of blessings for you. Psalm 107:21-30. Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Let them sacrifice thank offerings and tell of his works with songs of joy. Some went out on the sea in ships, they were merchants on the mighty waters. They saw the works of the Lord, his wonderful deeds in the deep. For he spoke and stirred up a tempest that lifted high the waves. They mounted up to the heavens and went down to the depths, in their peril their courage melted away. They reeled and staggered like drunkards, they were at their wit's end. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and he brought them out of their distress. He stilled the storm to a whisper, the waves of the sea were hushed. They were glad when it grew calm, and he guided them to their desired haven. Today's title is Thank God at the Sea of Storm. One of the major differences between Christianity and other religions lies in the role of thanksgiving. For most religions, people are obligated to satisfy what their gods require to earn the favor of their gods. But in Christianity, God first gives salvation and other favors to the people who fundamentally do not deserve God's favor. God doesn't require anything in return from people. But he expects them to have a thankful heart and love for God. Apostle Paul said that it is the will of God for us in Christ to be thankful in all circumstances. Today's psalm also has the theme of thanksgiving. It starts with a similar statement to that of Apostle Paul. Verse 21-22 says, Let them give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Let them sacrifice thank offerings and tell of his works with songs of joy. But it goes on to show a dramatic example of God's salvation for which we should be thankful. It shows what happened to some merchants who went out on the sea in ships. The ship must have sailed out in fine weather. Everybody on the ship expected a safe voyage. We can picture in mind all the people aboard as confident and happy. Then all of a sudden, a tempest stormed the ship. As the tempest rages and roars, the ship mounted up to the heavens and went down to the depths in their peril. Their courage melted away. This may sound so dramatic. But a friend of mine who went through a tempest on the sea told me that this is exactly what he went through at sea. My friend said they indeed reeled and staggered like drunkards, they were at their wit's end. Here we see merchants became totally powerless before the powerful storm. There is nothing they can do but to cry out to God. What do you think? Did you ever go through a storm like this? I am sure we all did one way or other. This seafaring experience may look dramatic. But I believe this sudden stormy scene realistically depicts our life, which we often describe as the sea of agony. In the sea of life, the exact same storm either lurks beneath us or hits us. If it is quiet and peaceful, it is God's grace. If it rages and roars suddenly, there is nothing we can do but cry out to God. But thank God. When we cry out to God, he stills the storm to a whisper. The waves of the sea will be hushed. He guides us to the haven that we desired. Isn't this amazing? Yes, it is awesome. So what can you do to such an awesome God and amazing salvation? Indeed, nothing but to give thanks and tell of his great works. How is your life going at the sea of storms? How thankful are you for God who holds it down or stills it?